Hello, space fans, and welcome to another edition of Space Fan News. This week, NASA's Juno mission to Jupiter completes its first flyby of the Jovian planet, and in spite of the SpaceX accident at Cape Canaveral this week, NASA says the launch of OSIRIS-REx to Bennu is still on track. On August 27th, NASA's Juno probe made the first of its 36 close flybys of the planet Jupiter. Immediately after arrival at the Jovian planet on July 4th, the mission began readying Juno and its instruments for taking data in preparation of this flyby. The time of closest approach with the gas giant was around 9:44 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, which was about 13:44 Universal Time, last Friday, when Juno passed about 4,200 kilometers or 2,600 miles above Jupiter's swirling clouds. At the time, Jupiter was traveling at 208,000 kilometers per hour, which is about 130,000 miles per hour, with respect to the planet. According to the Juno team, this flyby was the closest one of all the flybys Juno will do around Jupiter during its prime mission. The project manager reported that the early post-flyby telemetry indicates that everything is working as planned and Juno is firing on all cylinders. Now, there will be 35 more close flybys of Jupiter planned during Juno's mission, with the last one being in February of 2018. The August 27th flyby marked the first time Juno had its entire suite of science instruments activated and looking at the giant planet as the spacecraft zoomed past. Now, they are still processing the data taken last week, and it will be released sometime down the road, but a handful of images from Juno's Visible Light Imager, or JunoCam, are expected to be released in the next couple weeks. Those images will include the highest resolution views we've ever had of the Jovian atmosphere and will give us the first glimpse of Jupiter's north and south poles. Now, as I've reported to you many times, the orbit of Juno is unique. It flies in a polar orbit, which will give us unprecedented views of Jupiter's north and south poles, promising an entirely new perspective of the largest planet in our solar system. And as new data are released, I'll be sure to keep you posted. Next, by now, most of you have probably already heard about the explosion that rocked Cape Canaveral yesterday. Things went wrong at about 9:07 a.m. local time as SpaceX fueled the 230-foot Falcon 9 during a practice countdown, which were all a part of preparations for a planned early Saturday launch of a communication satellite for the Israeli company Spacecom. Now, this explosion was also devastating to Facebook because it had leased capacity on that satellite in partnership with a French satellite operator as part of its effort to expand broadband internet service in sub-Saharan Africa. Now, this static fire test was intended to culminate in a brief firing of the booster's 9 Merlin main engines. But before that happened, flames engulfed the rocket's upper stage, the first in a series of explosions that shook buildings miles away and sent a plume of smoke billowing skyward. Now, SpaceX is, of course, investigating, but it may be months before they find the root cause of the explosion. It was the second time in just over a year that SpaceX has lost a Falcon 9 rocket, which is slated to launch NASA astronauts for the first time as soon as next year. Now, no one was injured, but the accident could ground SpaceX for weeks or months, depending on its cause and the extent of the damage to Launch Complex 40. But if there is a positive that can be said about this terrible accident and setback for SpaceX, it may be that just a mile to the north, sitting on the launch pad getting ready for its send-off on September 8th, the OSIRIS-REx spacecraft and the United Launch Alliance's Atlas V rocket that will send it on its way were not affected by the explosion. So NASA said today in a statement, quote, "The launch for NASA's OSIRIS-REx mission remains on track for September 8th. Initial assessments indicate that the United Launch Alliance's Atlas V rocket and OSIRIS-REx spacecraft are healthy and secure at Space Launch Complex 41, which is 1.1 miles from SpaceX's launch pad where the incident occurred," unquote. So there is that. Now, if you want more information on what OSIRIS-REx will be doing, check out SFN 174 I did just a few weeks ago, where I told you all about the mission's goal of traveling to the asteroid known as Bennu, mapping the surface, and returning a sample of it back to Earth. Well, that's it for this week, space fans. I hope you have a great holiday weekend. Thanks to all SFN Patreon patrons who make SFN possible. Thank all of you for watching. And as always,